Hey guys, welcome to Team Passions video vlog. I'm here with Lance Gibson. He's a mixed martial arts instructor, trainer, and a former MMA fighter. Lance, thank you for being with us today. We appreciate it. Just have a few questions for you. First and foremost, can you tell me a little bit about yourself and your gym?
Well, my name's Lance Gibson. I own Gibson MMA. Been in business since 1997, for 15 years. One of the first schools in Canada to teach MMA, and one of the first names that, you know, we're fighting UFC and win. I fight in Japan, a retired number one fighter in the world with the shooting organization, and I continue to pass on my passion to young Canadian kids, ladies, and professional athletes within the UFC as well.
And roughly how many students do you currently have?
Ranges. You know, it ranges from 250 to 300. I'm not really worried about numbers. That's about good people. I've learned over the years, trained top fighters in the world, top fighters in Canada. As long as you're a good person, you get good morals, I'll teach them.
And which fighters have you trained with?
Canadian ones. I've trained Walter Gill, which is one of the top fighters around. He's fought in my student as well. Two local guys, including Todd Gallenberg, Tyler Jackson, Ryan Diaz. They're all kin champions, but maybe the ones I focus on is Julia Budd, one of the top women in the world. She's one of my top students. She's stuck with me for a long time, and she's really good. She's fight for us. And then, I trained Quentin Jackson, who's one of my fighters as well, for two camps. I trained him to victories. Devin Cole, the Strike Force fighter, beat Joe Vita Cole, the UFC fighter, and I got more guys coming following. I picked the teams.
And what was the experience like training with Quentin Jackson?
Oh, great. Quentin's a good guy. Quentin's a good guy, a good friend, but you know, he's not the easiest guy to train. That's why they bring me in, because I don't really take too much crap from anybody. So pretty much, I've been brought in as a head coach. Put him in shape, and we did for two fights. I did decide not to go back for the Jones fight because me and Eric don't see eye to eye.
And what's your opinion on the UFC taking the mainstream route to Fox as a partnership?
I love it because it educates people who don't have the money to buy a pay-per-view, but that's what boxing did. So boxing had big fights that normal TV didn't have the pay-per-views. It just brings it more away. When I fought, I couldn't get a sponsorship. And I'm fighting all around the world. I come out to Canada, couldn't get anything. So it's actually good for sponsorships and fighters. Because we're hungry, we want to make money, and we're going to make a living.
And do you use social media for your business?
I do. I don't have my students. I don't really do Facebook, some of my students do. Twitter I use because I go back and forth, and I guess you get fighters who want to talk to you and want me to train them. And then I use MySpace back in the day.
So, what works for you and what doesn't work for you about you started social media? Do you feel like Twitter works for you?
Twitter works because people want to know if your fans and what you're talking about. Facebook, I honestly don't think Facebook is personally what a martial arts school. People talk about what they're part of, but really, realistically, it's coming to the doors. You know, it's my clothing line and your reputation alone brings customers in. It's not Facebook.
And what are your thoughts about mixed martial arts training towards social media?
I think it's cool. It educates more people, but I think that, there's a certain, it's good, but I just don't necessarily think that it is, it's going to bring students necessarily through your door. But it educates the public, which is cool.
Do you have any thoughts that you would like to share with the viewers who look up to MMA Canadian icons like yourself?
I just think that be a good person, live a clean life, and be a good person. Morals and integrity is number one. You want to be a fighter. Any guy who wants to be tough and go up there, they're not fighters. Just be a normal person with integrity. Empty your cup, be humble, and just take the path as it comes and be a good person. You know, these guys who play all these parts in the Ultimate Fighter show, that's not what real fighters are about. It's a reality show.
UFC 143. Jones or Machida, what are your predictions?
Try Bone Jones.
Knockout?
I think he's going to finish him with elbows in the ground eventually, wear him out.
And lastly, your best pound-for-pound fighter in the world, in your opinion?
Anderson.
Well, there you guys have it. Thank you, Lance Gibson, and thanks for viewing. It's from Team Passion, host Amarvir Sohal. Until next time, we're tapping out.